I borrowed a fine vessel from the noted Mr. Brown, headed to my favorite lake about 19 miles from town. I tied on my bivisible, the one them big ones like. I barely hit the water, oh, there was one hellacious strike. And as this monster battled, I was happy through and through in my tin canoe. Well, I thought this was my lucky day, but then I thought again. Sky began to darken, rolling thunder, spewing rain. I was about a mile from shore when the lightning did begin, 'cause then I fully realized the trouble I was in. It's odd when something biblical starts happening to you in a tin canoe. In a tin canoe. In a tin canoe, I'm asking you, what do you do? I'm asking you, what do you do in a tin canoe? With the lightning creeping ever closer through the rain, I pondered how, when I was young, I used to play with trains. I'd roll them round my tiny track, oh brother, I did thrive. I said one day, when I get big, it's one of those I'll drive. So as the lightning found the mark, I had to marvel how I never got to be a conductor then, but I surely am one now. In a tin canoe, in a tin canoe, what do you do? I'm asking you, I'm asking you, what do you do in a tin canoe? Fried, of course I died, I met my worldly fates. Found myself delivered up to heaven's pearly gates. As I started thinking about this series of events, it seemed a silly way to go, just wasn't making sense. So I asked my heavenly Father, Lord, how did this come to pass? He looked down on me from a mighty golden throne. He looked down on me with an exquisite knowledge, and he said to me in a voice with the warmth of a million benevolent suns, you ain't got no fishing license, so I get to kick your ass in a tin canoe. In a tin canoe, I'm telling you, that's what I do. I'm telling you, that's what I do, yeah.